Kia ora koutou. Just a quick word to say that Mana is very, we're very proud to stand shoulder to shoulder with all of you here and with the Palestinian people of Gaza and the West Bank. And we've taken a bit of flak from the media for that, but in fact that's really important that we have organisations standing up and standing up for the truth, because we've still got these lies that come through the mainstream media about the situation in Gaza. We've still got sort of an automatic default position of support for Israel from our government and from too many of our political leaders. It's a real shame that you cannot fit a cigarette paper between the policies of National and Labour towards Israel and Palestine. And that's a real tragedy, because I know a lot of Labour supporters, a lot of Labour voters, probably most Labour voters, would want to be standing with Palestinians. So if we can get that message out there, that's really important. I think I do need to say this again and again. We need to tell ourselves and tell our friends that this issue is nothing to do with rockets being fired from Gaza into Israel. The reason those rockets are being fired is because the people of Gaza are resisting an occupating and occupying army, which is the Israeli army. And if we say to the people of Gaza, you're not allowed to fight back against that invading army, that's the same as we would be saying to the French resistance who fought against German occupation of France during the Second World War. Does anyone say the French resistance shouldn't have fought back? Of course they should. They were fighting against German occupation of their country. Palestinians are fighting against Israeli occupation of their land. They're standing against the theft of their land day in, day out. They're standing against the UN, a country which is in defiance of United Nations resolution, Security Council resolution, demanding that Israel withdraw to the 1967 borders. Israel ignores those Security Council resolutions. It ignores international law. It says we're above all of those laws. And anyone who fights back against us, we're going to call them a militant, we're going to call them a terrorist, we're going to call them all kinds of names. And it's a tragedy that in New Zealand, most of our media are still following that line. Whenever a Palestinian teenager picks up a rock to throw at an Israeli soldier, they're called militants. Well, let's have a hell of a lot more militants. Let's have a lot more militancy in fighting against the occupation of Palestine. So it's really important that we get that perspective right. So when we hear people talk about, oh, rockets being fired, let's say, let's get this boycott of Israel going until Israel abides by international law, until they support United Nations resolutions, until they get out of Palestinian land, until they stop stealing Palestinian land, until they start behaving like a civilized country that they want us to believe they are. So the similarities here with the situation in South Africa, just very briefly, I don't want to go on here, people, but these are really important things to say. That 1948 was the year that the Afrikaner Nationalist Party was elected to power in South Africa with its apartheid policies. And it was the year that the United Nations said to Israel, yes, you can form a Jewish state in the Middle East, but it must not be formed at the expense of the people already living there. And of course, Israel has ignored that. And that state was established, and it was established by the ethnic cleansing of Palestinians from the land that Israel now occupies. So 1948, both those things happened, and in Israel now, even within the borders of Israel itself, if you are a Jewish person, you are a citizen of Israel, and you are a national of Israel. But if you're a Palestinian, you can be a citizen of Israel, but never will you be able to be a national of Israel. So a Jewish person can come from anywhere in the world, never having any connection whatever with the Middle East, and they can become a citizen and a national of Israel. But people who have lived there for thousands of years, Palestinians and their families, are denied entry, are denied the opportunity to settle there, and are denied the opportunity to return to their land and their homes that they had before. So Israeli law is based on apartheid. It's based on two grades of citizenship. A citizenship that depend, that is a first class citizenship for Jewish people, and second and third class citizens for everybody else. So it is, it's a racist system, Zionism, it's an apartheid system, and we need to isolate Israel in the same way that we successfully isolated South Africa and brought change to that country. Kia ora koutou.